Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to share with you my Amazon Prime grocery delivery for this week. My hope is that you get some ideas as to what you can get at the grocery store for your healthy healing journey. So watch the video, ask your questions. I can't wait to hear your thoughts on this video. Let's get into the grocery haul.
Okay, this was my Amazon Prime Whole Foods haul, and I want to share with you the things that I got. My house was pretty much empty, and I'm going to be doing a lot of juicing this week along with my salads and fruit bowls and things that I like to make in smoothies. Let me just show you what I got. And all of these foods that I'm showing you are for helping you to heal from any kind of reproductive issue that you have, whether it is fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, ovarian cysts, heavy bleeding. So the first thing that I have here is some chopped organic kale. I'm going to use that in some of my juice recipes, as well as smoothie recipes. Then I've got some beets here. Beets, beets, beets. There's three large beets there. Beets are absolutely awesome for building the blood, alkalinizing the body, moving out toxins, and just neutralizing disease. So if you haven't started using beets, use them in your salads, use them in your smoothies, use them in your juice recipes. And then I've got some Bartlett pears. I think these are Bartlett pears, or they're red pears. I want to say Bartlett, but these pears are absolutely delicious. I cut them up and I put them in my fruit bowls, or I just have one for a snack, or you can just put it in your smoothie. Ginger, an anti-inflammatory. Ginger is absolutely wonderful for helping to heal the digestive system, which is one of the things we need when we're trying to heal reproductive issues. So if you have also menstrual pain, add them to your juices. You can even grate ginger up and put it on top of your salads. Ginger can be used in your stir fries. I mean, they're are tons of uses, but the main way that I like to use ginger is by putting them in either like a little chunk in my smoothie, a little chunk in my juice, or grating it over top of my salad. It adds flavor. I'm often asked if you can eat yogurt, and regular dairy yogurt, absolutely not, but there are some brands that are very clean. This is a clean yogurt. This is living coconut yogurt. You can even make this yourself. I have a recipe on my YouTube channel where you can make it yourself. But the reason that I like this brand is because the only ingredients in this brand is raw young coconuts and raw young coconut water, along with probiotic cultures. It is very pure. This is a good quality product. So if you're going to eat yogurt, make sure that it's a good quality product and that it is not made from dairy, because if it has junk in it, if you can't understand the ingredients, then it is a detriment to your healing process. Okay, so I've got some Kalamata olives. I like a good quality olive if I'm going to use olives at all. And I've got some dill weed. I love spices. I add spices to my salads because it makes my food taste delicious. I also add them to my steamed vegetables or my stir fries or my vegetable soups. So that's why I'm always stocking up on spices. So when I run out of a spice, I replace it. And also I add new spices as I see them. But when I choose spices, they don't have any funky ingredients in it. So for example, this spice just has dill weed in it. You know, you don't want things with preservatives in it because it goes against your healing process. Same thing with the Kalamata olives. The only thing in this particular brand is the olives, water, red wine, vinegar, and it has sea salt. And if you're not doing salt, what you do is you rinse the olives off before you put them into whatever dish you're using them in. Okay, here I've got some vine ripened tomatoes. I love vine ripened tomatoes because they're juicy and they just taste good. But my favorite tomato is an heirloom tomato. So if I can't find those or if they're not reasonably priced, I will use the vine ripened tomatoes in my salads. Next, I have some jalapenos. I like to add jalapenos to my soups, to my salads. My husband likes to add them to his smoothies. I can't stand that. I don't like hot sat smoothies, but if you like a kick in your smoothies, this is gonna help with circulation and it's going to help to detoxify your body as your blood is moving throughout your body quickly from the actual pepper stimulating that circulation. So it's a good addition to your meals. Also, I've got apples that I'm going to add to my juices. That's how I sweeten my juices most of the time. I use apples, especially my green juices. And so I got a bag of apples there. Then I've got a bunch of dandelion greens, which is tremendous for building the blood and cleansing your organs and glands that are associated with reproductive health. So if you can add dandelions to your salads, to your smoothies, to your green juices, that's going to be a plus. So this here is a bit extravagant. I bought pre-cut, pre-washed fruit. I was being lazy. I don't suggest you do this. What I suggest you do is buy fruit, cut it up, and prepare it for yourself so that you can grab and go. Because this was quite expensive. This was, like for example, this was 0.8 pounds and it was $6.99 a pound, so I paid $5.59 just for this little container. I don't recommend it. If you can afford to do it, do it. It will save you time and it'll get you out of a crunch if you need that. So here I have cucumbers, and I like to use cucumbers for not only my salads but also my juices. I have 6 cucumbers here that I'm going to be using this week for my juices. Cucumber is good for the skin, but it also hydrates and flushes the toxins out of your body, neutralizes disease and bacteria that contribute to reproductive problems. So add this to your regimen. If you don't juice, you can cut a cucumber up and put it in your smoothie. It's also going to help your hair if you have hair loss issues. Adding cucumber is nothing but a benefit. So lately I have been on a lime kick. I add lime to all of my salads, regardless if I make a salad dressing or not. I'm normally pairing the lime with adding cilantro to my salad and then putting whatever other ingredients I like in it. It seems like it's a game changer when you add lime to your salad. So here I have some romaine lettuce. This is my absolute favorite lettuce to put in my salads. I have 3 heads here, and these aren't really big heads. These are small heads, so for each one of my salads, I'll probably use about a head, and I may mix it with some other greens like spinach or arugula or something like that. Here I have some white quinoa. I only like white quinoa. I don't like red or black or any of the other color, dry color quinoa. It tastes funny to me, but my key to making good quinoa is to rinse it. Regardless if it's been pre-rinsed or not. If you'd like to see how I make good quinoa, there is a video that I did on my channel and I will link it right here so that you can add this to your rotation, because some people say that they don't like quinoa, and I think it's just because it doesn't turn out nice and fluffy and the texture's kind of off. But if you can get it nice and fluffy, it tastes really good. So these days, the only thing I use quinoa for is just to add a little bit to my salads, just to give it a little bit more oomph, to make me feel a little bit more satisfied whenever I eat it. So that's what I use quinoa for. I don't sit and eat bowls of quinoa and beans or anything like that like I have in the past, because it seems to be too heavy for my digestive system to eat so much of that at one time. So if you're gonna eat quinoa, just try not to eat more than a cup of it per day. Okay, so I've got some Thai basil here. You can use any kind of basil you want. But the reason I buy things like basil and dill, fresh herbs, is because when I add them to my dishes, whether it is my salad or my soups, or you can even add herbs to your smoothies, it just gives it a different depth of flavor. And some people say, well, there's nothing to eat on this diet, Chelsea, or on this way of living, Chelsea. And yes, there is. You just have to learn a new way. So Thai basil is one of those things that you can add to your foods to give them different flavor dimensions. And then I've got some celery here, organic celery. I've got two bunches, and I'm going to add these to my juices this week. And then this is my favorite kind of kale. This is dinosaur kale or lacinato kale. This kale is going to be used in potentially probably juice, not my salads, but you can also use them in your smoothies as you rotate your greens. Some people will put spinach in every smoothie. You need to rotate your greens. So this week you might use spinach. Next week you might use kale. Next week you might use chard or whatever green you are looking to choose at the grocery store. There's so many varieties, especially in the fall. Greens are grown and harvested in the fall. There's collards and turnips and mustards. There's all kinds of greens. So try the different rainbow of greens. Next green that I have been really digging lately is arugula. I've been putting them in my salads, mixing them with romaine. And the thing about arugula, I don't like eating it by itself because it's a little peppery. So it's a little spicy. So if you can't handle the spice, mix it with a green and you'll find that it tastes really good. I like to eat it raw. You can put it in your juice. You can also add it to your smoothies as well. Next, I got good old fashioned baby spinach. My husband loves baby spinach in his smoothies. So I don't love to eat baby spinach, but sometimes I will mix it in with other greens, especially if I'm running low, because we want to try and get at least a pound of greens every single day. My next favorite herb is flatleaf parsley. I like to put this in my juice and I love to mix it in with my salad greens. It just tastes delicious. So I have about 3 or 4 bunches here. Next is cilantro. I have been putting this in all of my salads. It just adds flavor that I didn't get in just my ordinary salad. So add any kind of herb that you can find. You can do fresh basil, you can do fresh dill, you can do fresh cilantro, you can do flatleaf parsley. There's a ton. You can use mint. There's all kinds of different herbs you can put in your salad just to give it a different flavor. And don't be afraid to try. That's one of the things that I find is that people are afraid to try new things. Don't be afraid. I've got some cherry tomatoes just for a different texture in my salad. Instead of just regular tomatoes, I just add the cherry tomatoes or grape tomatoes. And normally I like to buy organic tomatoes, but they didn't have them. So I'm just going to wash them and eat them. Next, I have some more lemons. I didn't buy many lemons because I have some in my refrigerator that I'm trying to use up. But I use lemons on everything. Lemons in my soups, lemons in my smoothie, because they have vitamin C that's gonna, if you are anemic, you will be able to absorb the iron better if you add something with vitamin C. Although lots of fruits have vitamin C, but it's great to add lemon to your smoothies, especially if you add greens, because if you don't like the taste of the greens, the lemon will neutralize the taste of the greens. So add lemon. Okay, I'm almost finished, ladies. And so then I have 3 5-pound bags of carrots, and this is for my juices for this week. If you are having trouble affording the produce for your juices, carrots are the best way to go. A 5-pound bag of carrots, I think, makes so a 32 ounce and plus a 16 ounce. So that was $4 for all that juice. I mean, you can go through the drive-thru and spend $6. You get what I'm saying. So that 32 ounces plus 16 ounces is like a meal and a half for me. You know, use your planning skills that you have, put that money where your health is, and don't waste your food when you purchase it, and you will go a long way. And the last thing I want to share with you, I think I've gotten everything here, is this pineapple. I'm going to cut this pineapple up and I'm going to use it in my fruit bowls. And also I might mix a little bit of the cocoa yogurt in. So there you have it, ladies. This is what I brought. and my Amazon Prime delivery. This week is primarily juices and salads and a little bit of fruit on the side, so to speak. And this is one of the ways that you heal from reproductive issues. If you eat like this, you cannot help but to heal. If no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.